The TikTok Women's Six Nations is back in Edinburgh, and after three defeats, Scotland will be looking for some home comforts here in the capital. But Italy, fresh from a fine victory over Ireland, are not a side to be taken lightly, so prepare for some tasty action on the pitch. Kickoff is just under 15 minutes away. Welcome to the Dam Health Stadium for round four of the Women's Six Nations. I'm delighted to say that joining me for this one is former Scotland captain Lisa Martin. Lisa, it's been a while since Scotland's last victory. It's certainly overdue, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely. It's 12 losses in the bouts. It's not exactly a record you want to be going in with here, but we've seen glimpses in the performances of the past few rounds that, you know, there is potential there, the win can be there. And hopefully today, you know, we'll get that first win that's going to change the tide.
Well, let's now get the thoughts of Scotland head coach Brian Eason. He's been speaking to our reporter Andy Burke.
Yeah, so it's vitally important. I think that first 20 minutes is going to be a big one for us. It's not something you'd say to the players in terms of, right, we must get it, because if it changes, it can be quite tough to chase. But look, we know it's important. We have, in terms of the way we want to play, we know what we're going to go after for the first 20, 25 minutes anyway. We've got a certain couple of lineouts we'll go after, a couple of scrums we'll go after as well. So look, we know how important that is, and we just want to get our noses in front. And then once we get our noses in front, we've shown, as you have already said, we've shown some good stuff already.
And you mentioned the home crowd. This place can be pretty noisy, but you need to give the fans something to feed off first and foremost.
Yeah, that's right, and that's why, as you say, the first 20 minutes is vitally important. If we can, even the odd penalty, just knock it over, just get that scoreboard going and get our noses in front of the scoreboard. We know what this crowd are like, and they can be noisy, and we're looking forward just to playing in front of the crowd that we have here. We love playing here, so get our noses in front, it'll be quite loud and enjoyable to watch.
Best of luck, Brian.
Thank you very much. Cheers.
Well, one match has already been played in round four, as Ireland hosted England. That ended Ireland 0, England 48. So, looking at the table, England stretched their lead at the top for now, and it shows just how important this match is for Scotland. They're sitting fifth and still to put their first points on the board. So, Lisa, what do Scotland need to do at the start of this game and really get themselves into it?
I think they need to just take some of the positives that we saw in the France game. You know, they played with some real speed, and the ruck speed they had as well was less than 2 seconds, and really stressed France there. And I think if they can continue doing that today, they're really going to put Italy under pressure and get some points on the board nice and early.
All right, well, let's get to it. The stadium is filling up. Let's go to our commentary team. Thomas Duncan is alongside Heather Lockhart.
Here we go then. The stage is set for what is arguably the most intriguing match of round four of the Women's TikTok Six Nations. A fiercely determined Scotland, chastened by 12 straight losses and hungry for a win on home soil against Italy. The great improvers of women's rugby, having finished as high as second in 2019 and on the back of a first ever World Cup quarter-final. It's sure to be a gripping contest in front of a healthy crowd of around 3,500 here at the Dam Health Stadium in Edinburgh. Alongside me is former Scotland prop Heather Lockhart. Heather, what does Scotland have to do to get that first win on the board?
I think there's some really good stuff been happening the last few matches, but I think just shore up the defence and then just have a lot more patience in the 22, kick for a lot more territory, I think, and then just have patience in the 22 and convert the chances when they arise. The rolling wall, we know, is a weapon. Lana Skeldon normally gets in the back of those, and we nearly got a try. Scotland nearly got a try from that last week in France, and they did really well for the first half hour, and then France got momentum going and broke away. But today, Italy, we know their strengths. Offloading game, Medea passing at number 10, Rigoni at 12, with Cillier at 13. So we know their strengths there. And the pack, the Italian pack, only missed two tackles. So Scotland are going to have patience to break the Italian defence down.
Well, here comes Helen Nelson, the Scotland fly half and vice-captain, leading her country out onto the pitch as she prepares to win her 50th cap. A proud moment for her and her family. A former alpine skier for Scotland in her youth, but she's done not bad turning to rugby as both teams take to the park in the shadow of Murrayfield Stadium in the west end of Edinburgh. It's a shame about the conditions. It was sunny at one point, but the clouds have come in. There's a real wind whipping about, and it's cold. The players will need to adapt, perhaps. There has been rain forecast that was spitting a bit earlier. Potentially a greasy, artificial pitch and ball. As the teams line up and prepare for the anthems. Well, Scotland just desperate to get that first win. 12 straight defeats. Three losses so far. Italy started with tough losses, two against France and England. Although they ran France close, 12 points to 22 they lost. There is the Princess Royal, patron of Scottish rugby, of course, of many years. She will be introduced to the players. And Heather, as the players prepare for the pre-match ceremonials. It's quite a while from when they leave the sanctity of the dressing room to kicking off the action. How do you deal with that as a player?
Yeah, I think the Scotland team players have alluded to it. There's a tunnel that you walk through between the changing rooms to into the Damhill Stadium, and they really like that because the fans get behind them there and they can feel the energy. So they'll be looking to keep that energy going for the start of the match.
Well, the Princess Royal will be presented to the teams alongside the Scottish Rugby President Colin Rigby and the Federation of Italian Rugby Deputy Vice President Giorgio Morelli. There's a royal salute by Piper Craig Scanlon from Foghollen Bathgate Pipe Band. Princess Royal will meet the Italian players first, and Italy are a dangerous side, Heather, there's no question about that. They weren't sparkling last week against Ireland, but they scored three fantastic tries, didn't they? So that is the threat that they can pose Scotland this afternoon.
Very much so. Melissa Dinka, number 11, two tries last week, one really outstanding one. Beatrice Rugoni as well, setting them up for her. So we know their strengths there. So Scotland are really on it. But it's good conditions, although it is slightly damp and the wind is up. But hopefully we'll see some running rugby from both sides today.
Yeah, well, Italy have certainly had Scotland's number in recent meetings. They've won 10 of the last 11 between the sides, including six in a row. Scotland's last win was back in 2017 at Broadwood. Chloe Rowley, who's playing this afternoon, scored both tries in a 14-12 win. Heather, I believe you were on the bench for that match. What were your memories of it?
Yeah, well, that was the 2017. Scotland finished fourth, the highest finish for a while there. So wins against Wales, close encounter with Wales in round three, and then in round five, finishing off with a strong win against Italy. Scotland were down and came back. Chloe Rowley getting clear of the match.
Well, it's a bit of a new era for Italy as well. Long-serving coach Andrea De Giandomenico departed after leading them to a first World Cup quarter-final in the autumn of last year. Giovanni Raineri, a former Italy centre, now in charge. He's had a good coaching school as well down in South Africa alongside Razi Erasmus and Nien Abert. Not a bad set of people to learn from. Is he Princess Royal? Works her way down the line, a long line, and the Scotland players waiting. And these must be nervous moments, Heather, for the players. It's a long wait for them to before they get into the thick of the action, which is what they're desperate for.
Absolutely, but I think it's an opportunity to soak up the atmosphere. And Scotland, this is the first of two games at home, and Italy are very much looking forward to the game as well. So it's just an opportunity to get prepped. Some are talking, some are not. Everyone's got a different way of dealing it, but fantastic that the Princess Royal is here today and to support the match.
Absolutely. She is shaking hands with Helen Nelson to win her 50th cap. Rachel Malcolm, the captain, alongside the Princess Royal, spoke about trying to make those improvements which will result in a win. They hung in the fight for the first half against France, created some decent opportunities, couldn't take them, and then the French really turned on the style power in the second half and ran out comfortable winners. But there have been glimpses of good stuff. Chloe Rowley there, she's been at the heart of a lot of Scotland's best attacking play in this championship, the fullback. Four tries in her last seven Six Nation appearances. They'll be looking, Heather, to get ball in her hands plenty this afternoon.
Yeah, very much so. She's made 366 metres, top scoring for the Scotland team on that. So she'll be looking for every opportunity on the counter-attack. She really finds the gap, just lightning quick feet.
Well, kick-off fast approaching here at the Damhealth Stadium in Edinburgh. Scotland back on home soil. We'll look to use the encouragement this crowd will give them to get over the line. They were away to England and France, of course, in this championship. Two of the toughest fixtures away from home. Home loss up to Wales was the most disappointing of the three. Chance to finish strongly here against Italy at home and Ireland at home next week. Two very winnable games as we prepare for both national anthems. First up, Fratelli d'Italia for the visitors. People's favourite anthems, the Italian anthem, always rousing, enjoyed by some of the Italians in front of us here at the Damhealth Stadium. Now time for the crowd here to warm their voices up with a rendition of Flower of Scotland.
Yeah.
Alison Nair getting quite emotional on the occasion of her 50th cap, soaking it all in on what she hopes will be a very special occasion marked with a victory.
Best of wishes, Helen, absolutely fantastic. Sure, well, she'd like nothing more than to celebrate a win on her 50th.
Well, Scotland have shuffled their pack from defeat by France. Jade Conkle-Roberts made her comeback at number 8 last week and moves into the second row in place of Lindsay O'Donnell. That means Evie Gallagher switches back to number 8 as Rachel McLaughlin returns at open side. Helen Nelson has a new halfback partner on her 50th cap as Mary McDonald replaces Katie Mattinson. Lisa Thompson moves out to outside centre to accommodate the returning Meryl Smith after Emma Orr's concussion last week. Kareem Grant is back on the wing and Fran McGee is fit enough to start after an ankle knock in France. Well, Italy are without their top tackler Francesco Scorbini and captain Elisa Giordano through injury. Sara Tunesi shifts from the second row to blindside flanker. That leaves space for Valeria Pedrighi to come into the second row. The only change in the back line is at full-back, where Vittoria Ostuni-Minuzzi is fit again and replaces Beatrice Capomaggi. Watch out for the supremely talented centre pairing of Beatrice Ragoni and Michaela Sillari. The versatile Ailey Sinclair is back on the Scotland bench for this one. Italy have plenty of youth in their ranks, as well as 35-year-old scrum half Sara Baratin, who could win her 115th cap. The match referee is Aurélie Goiselot from France, who took charge of Italy's win over Ireland last week. She did penalise them 14 times though, 10 at the ruck, which is something they'll be looking to sort, while Scotland could potentially exploit that at the breakdown. Well, the ceremonial is over. It's time for the action. Both teams desperately seeking victory. A chance to finish potentially in the top three of this TikTok Women's Six Nations. England already continued their relentless march in search of a fifth straight title. But there's plenty to play for here at the Damhealth Stadium, Heather.
Absolutely. Just great take there by Jade Conkle-Roberts just to set things up.
Solid start from Scotland. Mary McDonald making her first start of these championships at scrum half. Gets the ball away, but it's a charge down. And then Italy fumble. Meryl Smith clatters one up. But we'll come back for a knock-on. Meryl Smith straight into the thick of the action.
Yeah, she's been playing in the Celtic Challenge matches, played in round one or two, and actually kept her eye on the ball well there. Just a knock-on there by Italy, but she tidied up well. She's a good linking play with Helen Nelson at 10.
Well, we'll see who can get the upper hand early on at scrum time. Scotland were competitive last week against a very good French pack. As McDonald gets that one in efficiently and away. Here's Thompson. Good kick into space. Back to Ostuni-Minuzzi. Looks up. Takes the ball to the line, tries to spot a gap. She's taken down by Malcolm. Italy just reset as they look to exit. Taken up by Vecchini. There's Madia, fly half to Dinka, who's such a threat with ball in hand. Maris, the prop, carries. There's Silari, Madia, thought about the offload to Muzzo. And Stefan puts the box kick in. Penalty to Italy for a high shot.
Italy just going through some good phases there. McDonald just on the high tackle.
Yeah, some stray hands from Mary McDonald. And Italy get themselves up into Scotland territory. line-out wasn't exactly their strong point last week against Ireland, Italy. Vecchini was a bit erratic with the throw. Let's see what she can do here. And she finds the player nicely. Italy on the march forward. Stefan. Scotland just trying to slow that ball down. Stefan. Italy go wide. Here's Muzzo. Ostuni Minuzzi. Rolli gets up off the line to make the tackle. Scotland trying to turn this into a maul here. And they have turned over. Excellent defence from Scotland. They spotted the opportunity to keep Ostuni Minuzzi up. And they've forced the turnover.
Yeah, Italy did well. Good line out. Duca, their main line out taker. And good offload there to Ostuni Minuzzi. But Scotland, fierce defence there. Gallagher in there. Look, Chloe Rolli holding the ball out. Rachel Malcolm. And if they don't use it, then it's a turnover.
Another scrum. The Scotland front row of Bartlett, Skeldon, Belial played, started all the matches so far. The first one was solid.
Six.
See if Italy can put Scotland under pressure here. Giada Franco, the number eight, pops her head up. And it's a bit loose from Scotland. Thompson cleans up, but they're in a spot of baller. But Rolli, calm as you like, takes and puts the boot through it. Here's Minuzzi. The chase from Scotland is good. Rolli's up after her own kick. Here's Dinka. So good in broken field. Dinka.
Advantage.
Spilled.
Advantage over.
Nelson clears, but only as far as Rigoni. Stefan digs for the ball. Here's Madia. Locatelli. Giada Franco, big carrier for Italy. Out the back to Madia, gets the fend in on Skeldon, but the hooker scrags her to the deck. Stefan puts the little kick up, tries to put Scotland under pressure. Nelson's back. Goes forwards, tackles come in.
Tackle, Willis!
Scotland back down their own end of the field. Here's Thompson, steps in. And that is a really good clearing kick from Lisa Thompson, and it forces the mistake. And Scotland have suddenly stolen 40 yards.
Yeah, they really had to work hard a couple of times. The clearance didn't quite go to plan, but they're forcing the error there from Locatelli. But some really good attacking play there. Dinka getting the break. They know how elusive she is. So Scotland are going to have to be on their watch.
First Scotland line out. Skeldon to throw in. Can't find Malcolm. Locatelli gets a hand up. Italy come again. Stefan, Madia, Rigoni, move it through the hands. Sileri. Ostuni Minuzzi tries to go on the outside. Through the hands, but not too many yards gained for the Italians. Here's Lucia Gai. Rigoni, always a good kicking option, and that's a neat little dink through to turn Scotland around.
Come see, come sa, just like, yeah, I'm quite happy with that. But yes, really, really, really good kicker. Madia doesn't kick so much, only eight kicks throughout the whole tournament so far. Rigoni really is the controller there. Ostuni Minuzzi looking threatening at that full-back position. Again, that back three, Scotland have to be on their guard.
Yeah, they do like to run it, Italy, that's for sure. Played some good stuff against Ireland last week. We're loose at times as well, but they take risks. The drive is on, Scotland use it. Malcolm. Nelson puts the kick in. And again, Italy don't take knock it one. Cleanly. And was that a knock-on from Astuni Manuzzi? It was. And Scotland again, forcing the error with some decent kicks.
Very much so. Both Nelson and Lisa Thompson putting a good boot there. Mutso having to work hard behind her. So that was excellent play there from the kick. Just forcing that. Just Astuni Manuzzi quite rangy, quite tall, having to bend down there.
She missed the Ireland game. Vittorio Astuni Manuzzi with injury, but back in the lineup. Usually very reliable back there, but
crouch.
Not on that occasion. Scotland scrum. And some good territory.
Set. Okay, we're stuck.
The French referee.
Let's go, my set, let's keep on.
Are you on again?
Just setting the front row straight. Hear the call there to Evie's feet. They want it cleanly through. Back to Evie Gallagher, Scotland number eight. Solid scrum from both teams. Scotland are away. Kareem Grant off her wing. Makes a few yards. McDonald. Here's Jade Conkle-Roberts. Always a willing carrier for Scotland. Nelson forced to go into the ruck, the fly half. Here's Malcolm, right past to Conkle-Roberts. What a thumping hit from Sara Tunisi. Scotland's go again though, Rowley. Gallagher and Italy, the ferocity of the defence. Tunisi again.
No hands, it's work. Work.
She is up for this one. Again, Scotland driven back. Smith, good line from Skeldon. Vecchini is in there trying to scavenge for ball. Nelson hits the line. Madia
not clear release. It's a tackle.
Is in there, but she's penalised for not releasing.
Yeah, we talked about at the beginning about the Italian attack, but the defence there was just outstanding. Tunisi there really getting and the line speed guy, double tackles. So Scotland, Lana Skelton showed you how to play around that. Just a bit of movement, cutting that line, and good territory here for Scotland.
Well, Sara Tunisi has the most dominant tackles of any player in these championships, and she's just added another two to her tally there with two thumping hits. But it is Scotland who have the ball down exactly where they want it, and a chance to test out that Italian defence once more. Skeldon goes to the back, claimed. And here goes Scotland on the mall. It's been a source of success for them in recent matches. Skeldon clutches the ball at the back. Scotland use it. Smith steps inside, goes for the line. Brought down by Rigoni. McDonald. Here's McMillan. Just a few metres away, Scotland. McDonald. Gallagher steps back. Again short. McDonald. Belisle driven backwards. Italy are not going to let Scotland cross this whitewash without a fight. Nelson goes out wide. Here's Thompson. Gets it away, the pass just wasn't quite there. Here's Grant.
No, Willis, no!
Conkle-Roberts, lovely pass for McLaughlin. Offloads to Louise McMillan, who's over for the try. Fantastic, patient build-up from Scotland. They kept the ball, they recycled, they went again and again. And finally, they break through. Louise McMillan with the opening try.
Just a lovely offload there from Jay Conkle-Roberts. Interplay, and that's Louise McMillan's first try for Scotland. Congratulations, Louise. That was a real team try. Great line there by Rachel McLaughlin. And just powered her way past two Italian defenders. Excellent play. Great start.
Yeah, that little pass there from McLaughlin is excellent. A bit of guile to go with the heft. And Louise McMillan with a great finishing touch. And now Helen Nelson will look to add the extras. She's kicked well when she's had the opportunity. Can she add the extra 2 points? Well, the wind's wreaking a bit of havoc off the tee. Here comes Lana Skeldon, who's going to get down and make sure that ball stays there. It's a good strike, but it just didn't quite shape in time.
Yeah. Next one, but yeah, very much so. Just seeing that try again. Great to see. Past Bikini and Sillery. Really good. Well done, Louise.
And that is Scotland's first points of any kind in the opening 20 minutes of matches in these championships. And what a boost it is with this crowd behind them.
Feet, play on,
and a chance to build on something. Gallagher does well. Clearing kick has good distance. Ostuni Minuzzi. Here's Giada Franco. Italy over halfway, but Meryl Smith is in there with a rip. Fantastic work from the Scotland centre. Now Gallagher's away. Bartlett holds off the tackle.
No, Bonnie's on.
McDonald, a try scorer, McMillan.
Stay.
Scotland edge towards halfway. Nelson opts to kick. Mutso is underneath it. And she'll have a go, stretch the legs. McLaughlin gets low and makes the tackle. And it's a penalty. Captain Rachel Malcolm in there.
I think it's
Evie Gallagher that's in. The turnover specialist for Scotland.
Yeah, just such a good low body position. Strong. Rachel leading them well just now, Rachel Malcolm.
And Scotland's already with a chance to build on their score from just a few moments ago. Leah Bartlett just has a word with Lana Skeldon, who goes for Malcolm, who manages to claw it back. McDonald retrieves it. Here's Conco Roberts, hits the line. Skeldon gets through a power of work every game she plays. McDonald, Nelson onto Smith. Good line, Lisa Thompson. Forward pass halts Scotland's momentum and just gives Italy a chance to breathe.
Jade Conco-Roberts just looking much more comfortable on the ball. Just the phase earlier. She played 47 minutes last week coming back from injury and just running through her. She'll have got confidence from that last week. And great to see her really taking the ball to the line. Slotting in there at second row. Not usually always plays there, but what an asset there just now. The scrums are going well. So, definitely something that she can lend her hand to.
Yeah, 9 carries and 9 tackles in her 47 minutes last week, Jade Conco-Roberts. But good to get her back on the pitch from a Scotland point of view. And the more minutes she plays, the better she'll get. Such an asset for Scotland, a leader in that pack. As the scrum goes down, but it's on we go. Stefan Rigoni. Madia. Ostuni Minuzzi. Only Mutso outsider.
No come.
It's another error. And again, Italy can't get any forward momentum.
Yeah, the Scotland defence just looking lively. Kareem Grant getting nice and low, and there's, yeah, just forcing the error. Just good pressure. We've got numbers. Scotland have got numbers.
Five handling errors from Italy already, as you can see there, and that was an issue last week against Ireland. They had a lot of them. Still scored three fantastic tries in which they knitted together some great passages of play, but if you put them under pressure, there are errors there to be forced.
Yeah, their expansive game, their offloading game lends it to that, and if it doesn't go to hand, then sometimes obviously the risk of the error.
Well, these teams know each other so well. Six Nations World Cup qualification as well, 18 months ago. Italy have had Scotland's number in recent years, but it's more often than not been fiercely competitive. And the opening 18 minutes or so has been the same here. Scotland with the crucial early try from Louise McMillan as they seek a first win in these championships. Gaia Maris, the Italian loose head, just getting some strapping on her arm.
Scotland know the Italian threat. They were up this match last year 10-3, so they know the counter-attacking threat, especially in the second half.
Crouch! Save! Bind! Set!
It's been a good contest at the scrum so far. Here we go again. McDonald whips the ball away. Scotland's kick. Stoney Manuzzi's caught slightly out of position, and then Fran McGee's straight up to make the tackle. Great kick chase from Scotland, and now the counter ruck comes in. Ball was out, says the referee.
15, over. Stay back.
Italy still have it. Rigoni clears our lines, but that's good territory gain for Scotland.
Very much so. Fran McGee last week had to go off injured after 8 minutes, and they are just showing her class, really putting the Italian defence under a lot of pressure there. Amazing what a kick chase can do.
Yeah, that was something that was perhaps missing in France last week. They put a lot of kicks in, found a lot of the French back three and Jesse Tremoulière, and then the chase just wasn't quite there. Scotland straight on it on this occasion.
Yeah.
The ball comes back by hook or by crook. Coco Roberts. Skeldon. Nelson takes the ball to the line. Lovely ball inside to Thompson. Big fend goes in. Locatelli was trying to get her hands on the ball there. Nelson, Conco Roberts again. Penalty for the Italians this time. Valeria Federighi, I think, getting in there and pouncing on the ball.
Some nice variation of play, but excellent. Yeah, Federighi over the ball, nice strong position. Scotland have got to release.
Seven carries already for Jade Conco-Roberts. She gets through a mountain of work, 25 metres made. Not bad for the opening quarter.
Very much. You know when she's got rhythm, it seems like she's got that rhythm today.
Vecchini throws in, goes all the way back to Lucia Gai.
No, eight, back!
Italy on the move. It's again spilled. Another handling error from the Italians.
Yeah, their number nine is they're getting in the way of our number nine.
Yeah,
every breakdown they're rolling into our nine. So
Scotland defence just really working super hard there.
Okay.
Rachel Malcolm just having a word with the referee here, saying, trying to point out and just say that they are lying in the ruck, slowing Scotland's ball down illegally. Looking for a bit of help from the referee.
There you are. Seven carries, 30 metres, six tackles.
Work rate, I think you call that.
Absolutely.
Bound. Set.
Another Scotland scrum. They've had a lot in these opening 22 minutes. Free kick, and on they go. Mary McDonald not hanging around. Here's Rowley, and this is what she enjoys. Ball in hand. It's Conco Roberts again. Jada Franco just halts her. Nelson. Scotland over the gain line. Bartlett. Nelson out to McLaughlin, who did really well to hold that. Nelson looks, can't quite find Smith, but the centre pounces on the loose ball and Scotland will have to reset. Back in their own half, Skeldon goes over the top of Sealery.
Wait!
Nelson puts the ball up. Ostini Manuzzi gathers. Oh, step inside. Dark sock to the 10-metre line. Regoni, the cross-field kick.
Great
but Rowley gathers. And you don't want to kick to Chloe Rowley. Italian penalty. And that is a shame for Scotland because... Okay. Chloe Rowley had got them nicely up the pitch there, but Italy doing the work at the ruck.
Yeah, a couple of breaks earlier, but there they go. Yeah. Again, strong position.
It was Sealery in there. And she's got five turnovers for Italy, which is the most of any of in the Italian squad, which is impressive for an outside centre.
Yeah, she's... 45 tackles, I think, as well. So her work rate is superb. She's a real compliment Rigoni at 12. It's a formidable centre partnership.
Yeah, they've caused Scotland plenty of pain over recent meetings with their quality.
Yeah, both players, player of the match, Rigoni in 2021 and Sillery in 2022.
Yeah, she got 10 of the 20 points Italy scored against Scotland last year. They have an injury in the front row as Lucia Guy was struggling there.
90th cap today, Lucia Guy, tight head prop.
Just wait,
made 96 metres against Scotland last year.
It's okay.
Pretty outstanding for a tight head prop, so she'll reset.
Yeah, she's okay, she's going to play on. And Beatrice Rigoni will thud this up towards the Scotland 22, but it's just over the 10 metre line. Didn't look too happy with that one. But it's a chance for the visitors to get on the front foot, get those backs into the game.
Not straight.
And not straight from Vicini, who is furious with herself. As I said earlier, it was a problem last week, the throw-ins from the line out.
Yeah, I saw them practicing in the warm-up. Bettoni, Melissa Bettoni had retired, the usual starting number two. So Vicini, young hooker, just 21, just making her way into international rugby and playing a lot of minutes this championships.
Yeah, Italy down in fifth for line-out success in these championships, just 73%. You can see that's an encouraging statistic. For both teams, really, they've won their own ball so far.
Set.
Scotland's scrum going well. Again, it's excellent from both sides, clean, and Scotland are away. Nelson, here's Fran McGee. Nelson's met on the gain line.
Tackle!
by our opposite number, Madia. Gallagher. Hard to pin down. Nice footwork from the number eight. Bartlett. There's space for Scotland if they can move it. Here's Smith. Tries the offload round the back and it's loose and Ragone stabs it through. Will it go out? It won't. Dinka's onto it. And it's going all the way through here and it's going to be a try. No! Alisa Dinka can't gather the ball. Metres from the Scotland try line. And the usually lethal Italian winger passes up a huge opportunity.
Yeah, it was a good kick through by Ragone and Dinka kept it in well. Just looking ahead slightly, just, oh, so close.
Yeah, maybe thought she'd already scored the try.
For anything.
Fantastic young player though, try against France. Missed the England game with injury. Player of the match in two tries last week against Ireland. Fantastic footballing skills on show. Just didn't quite, on this occasion, have the hands to match at the death.
Very much an opportunist, sees that a great, yeah, as you say, footballing skills, fantastic. Nice smile, she knows.
Yeah, she's annoyed at that one. But she'll go again the next time she gets a chance. And Scotland have to stand firm here at the scrum as they have done. 5 metres from their own line. Donald gets it away. It's trucked up. A penalty, Italy. Off feet, Scotland at the rock. And that is a result for the Italians.
What? Okay. Line, it's over, okay?
Words exchanged there between...
Yeah.
Christine Bilal.
Sitting.
Players got to stay on their feet, otherwise they get penalised, so that's the reason for the penalty here.
Okay, time is off. It's a scrum. Yeah, but we wait for the second row.
So, Italy are going to go for the scrum. They're going to back themselves.
But we wait. We have
to win this.
A for second row.
And get the balls in the hands of their dangerous backs. And Sara Tunisi is getting a bit of treatment. Steve Finger, perhaps.
Yeah. The scrum, certainly, for both sides. There's Scotland tight, the forwards there. It's been a good platform for both, really. Scotland especially. Line out a bit more scrappier. Not exactly clean ball. But opportunity here for Italy.
It's a stray contact lens for Sara Tunisi, has escaped. Hopefully she can get that back in. The Scotland and Italy just huddle up and try and work out what they're going to do here. Big set with 12 minutes to go till the break. Scotland in front, but they've not had much ball down the Italian end of the pitch since that Louise McMillan try. And now Italy with a really promising platform from the scrum, if they can get that right. Princess Royal watches on. And these are big moments, Heather.
Yeah, it's first jobs first. Italian back line getting ready. Medea's pass is outstanding, but scrum first.
Bye! Set!
Here we go. Italy trying to get a drive on, but Scotland are hitting back. Franco has it. She's going to go for the line here, Giada Franco. Is she over? She's short. Gets the ball back. Italy will go again. Vicchini. Scotland desperate. Again, it's short. Locatelli. Latches on, and they're over. Try, Italy.
On the line. No, on the line.
A fantastic riposte from the Italians. They took the opportunity from that scrum penalty And Giada Franco, the number eight, emerges, having dotted that ball down.
Excellent body position there, taking her opportunity well.
She is a powerful, powerful player, Giada Franco. Missed last year's Six Nations with injury. Such a fillip for Italy to have her back in that pack.
Yeah, was it Harlequins, now back in Italy, played with Jay Conkle Roberts.
Michaela Sillery, who's a pretty reliable kicker, will try and nudge her side in front. It's good. Italy have the lead for the first time.
Successful conversion for Italy, number 13, Michaela.
And Scotland header just have to try and reset and go again.
Yeah, that was a well-taken try. Franco going right, blindside off the scrum initially, and then those strong drives, patience, the forwards working together.
And you mentioned it earlier, Heather. Scotland were 10-3 in front of the break in this fixture last year and ended up losing 2013. So it can all turn quickly, and that's a perfect example.
Welcome.
As Ostuni Minuzzi in her own 22 fails to gather the restart. And it's uncharacteristic. She's made a couple of errors so far.
Yeah. Strong kicks from Scotland, but she'll shake it off. So just, yeah. Quite a bouncy surface. I think she's maybe just not quite used to the bounce of this. This is where home advantage definitely pays off. Scotland train here regularly.
Well, Italy just made a scrum platform work to their advantage very nicely, and now it's Scotland's turn.
Wait, on the night.
A gift from Italy.
Set.
Can Scotland take full advantage? McDonald puts the ball in. Gallagher fishes it out. Here's Thompson. Tries to force the pass away to Rowley. Italy.
No hands.
Pounce on the ball through Tunisi. That's unfortunate from a Scotland point of view. Stefan controls with her foot. It's the box kick in. Finds touch.
Yeah, Lisa Thompson, obviously back from GB7s, just slightly less room to play with, but good to see her out in that 13 channel. I think she can add value there.
Scotland just force it a wee bit there, Heather. Maybe try and just keep the ball like they did for the opening try.
Yeah, I think she'll know that.
McMillan takes that nicely. Namol is rumbling forward. Scotland aim to get up to that 22.
Don't change your mind.
Claims that Italy are changing their mind, but on we go. Rowley, big fend. Sillery clings to the ankles. Gallagher pass to Conkle Roberts, takes two to bring her down, and then Italy are lying in the ruck. Advantage to Scotland. Too little too late there, I think. Belisle picks up and drives forward, takes the opportunity when it's there, the prop. Scotland just inching towards the line.
Yes.
Advantage being Tackle. Played. Smith, Thompson flings the pass out to Corinne Grant.
Forward pass.
It's going to be brought back for a forward pass, but Scotland did have the advantage. Player still
Tackle
going.
Back off tackler, not falling.
Yes, Scotland are doing well in the close quarters actually at the moment. Maybe just keep it a bit tighter just for a little while, because they're definitely, like Barry McDonald, seeing space, darted through the ruck. Christine Belisle, lovely leg drive. So yeah, making yards there.
They'll put Italy's mole defence to the test here, that's for sure.
Last one was definitely cleaner ball, helped set up a solid mole.
And five.
McMillan takes. And Skeldon has it under a rock star. They'll look to
advantage. And
dart into space if you can, but it's down. McDonald digs out the ball. Smith. Our support from Thompson. McMillan looking for a second try. Gallagher, pass just evades her, but it's not gone forwards. Bikini's in there winning the ball.
I come back. Time is off.
We'll go back for penalty advantage again to Scotland.
Captain, Capitaine. J'ai la 5, elle rentre sur le côté après elle écroule. C'est une situation dynamique, ça sera carton jaune. 5.
Yellow card.
It's side entry at collapse. No opportunity to try.
Jordana Duca is going to spend 10 minutes in the bin.
5. Side entry collapsing.
Can I ask why it's not a penalty try? We've got momentum in
the No, at the moment when it's collapse, it's static ball, it's not dynamic, okay?
Yeah, Rachel Malcolm doing what all good captains do, just asking the question there, penalty try. The referee says no, but the disruption at that mall has cost Italy a player for 10 minutes of this game as we go past 5 minutes to half-time. Great chance, Scotland.
McMillan
secures ball again, and Skeldon will have another go. And Scotland have go forward. Gallagher gives Skeldon a shunt. They're over the line. Lana Skeldon scores. Celebrations all round at the Damhill Stadium. Scotland were denied illegally the first time. They wouldn't be denied again. And Lana Skeldon has a fourth try in her last 7 games. Prolific from the hooker.
Absolutely superb. Just a real forwards try there. Well worked, well taken at the line out. And just all working together. Really tight, really patient. And Lana finishing it off. Excellent play. The clean line out is definitely helping that to gather them all at the start. Louise McMillan took the last two, really clean.
Now the try scorer not off duty yet as she tries to keep this ball steady for Helen Nelson, who will look to add the extra 2 points. Well, it's another clean enough strike from Helen Nelson, but just didn't carry as she would have liked between the sticks, and it's a 3-point game. And it's a big 3 minutes now for both sides before the break. Scotland will want to make sure they go in the lead. Italy do have time to hit back, but they are a player down. Jordana Duca in the sin bin.
Stop.
Franco. Here's Rigoni. Kicks to space. Rowley covers. We'll put our own kick in with space in behind. Stefani's turned the scrum half. She will get there first. Has to go round Chloe Rowley. It's a nice play from the Italy scrum half, really calm, and Dinka crucially scragged to deck there by Jade Conkle-Roberts. Stefan nudges the box kick straight out, and it's another unforced error from Italy.
Yeah, I think their coach alluded to that. I just said it talked about their consistency, and I think they're sort of just knitting it all together rather than just just cutting out the unforced errors.
Scotland's line out. again, a notable improvement from last week. I'm sure Brian Easton has been working on it. They've been very solid at the set piece so far. Malcolm Gallagher's another one. Can Scotland finish this first half with a flourish? Skeldon. Nelson stabs the kick in behind. That's clever. Very clever from the Scotland fly half.
Yeah, just nice, sensible play. The restart was good as well by Scotland, which is crucial when you've just scored and it's just before half-time. And, yeah, certainly getting some territory. And Italian line-out in the 22.
Well, Italy will be forced to try and secure this. Play their way out. Scotland look to go in to the sheds. In front. Fakini goes short to our front row partner, Gaia Maris. Christine Vallejo tried the rip, to no avail. Italy still have the ball. Stefan under real pressure, the scrum half. Fakini, the hooker. Italy get the penalty, the clock's red, but they will have time to kick this to touch and play if they want to. Beatrice Regoni finds touch, and Italy will have to do something special to score from here, but they are certainly capable.
They used a short line out last week against Ireland. It's something that, with Duca off as well.
That not one quite. Isn't straight either. Fakini just not having half-time. A good time at the line out. And there is the half-time whistle. And it's been a very competitive first half. But tries from Louise McMillan and Lana Skeldon have Scotland in front at the break. Italy got on the board as well through Giada Franco. But at half-time at the Damhill Stadium, it's Scotland 10, Italy 7.
Well, Scotland back at home at a packed Damhill Stadium. What more could you want? It was important for Brian Easton's side to get off to a good start, and they did just that. Louise McMillan first on the score sheet. Italy still dangerous in attack, eventually taking the lead, but Lana Skeldon gets Scotland back in the lead just before half-time. What a brilliant start for Scotland. I'm delighted to say that we're joined again with Lisa Martin and Emma Wassell, who we can see is with a crutch. Can you just tell us actually what's happened?
Yes, I've had knee surgery. I got 3 weeks ago, so I am on the mend. Hopefully just a few more months and then I'll be back out on the pitch. But I'm on the way up now.
You're doing very well walking along the side of the pitch there. I'm very impressed because you're just 3 weeks
confident with the crutches.
Brilliant. Well, it's great to have you here. Hopefully we'll see you back on the pitch soon. We'll be coming to more a bit about you soon. But let's just talk about Scotland and that first half. Lisa, what were your thoughts on there? Good start from Scotland.
I think it was a great start. I think, as Brian has said, it was really important those first 20 minutes and to get the first points on the board, I think, was fabulous. And they've really set the tone, and that they're not to be messed with at home. They're here for one reason and one reason only, and that is to come at the end of this with a victory. And you've seen that start in that first 40.
And Emma, it was so important for Scotland really to get on the score sheet first, wasn't it? Especially against this Italy side.
Definitely. I think they're definitely trying to play a territory game, and it was really promising to see them get into the 22 for the first time and convert, something that I don't think we've done probably well enough in other games. Really positive to see Louise McMillan on the scoreboard there, and she's been a real leader.
Yeah, we can actually see that now. Lisa, could you just talk us through this try? Really good team effort from Scotland.
It's great patience from the forwards here. We're seeing lots of little pick and goals. Obviously, when we get in the 22, like Emma said, we're looking to convert and we're looking to be pretty sensible with it. We look to stretch them a little bit here, get to the edge. Yeah, a little bit scrappy here, but actually show lots of great composure to reset again, re-go, and again take it to Italy. And these break highs and those little tips here, I think, is hugely important. and then the second one there just by Rich McLaughlin off to Louise McMillan, and we're over. We know how much of a big carrier that Jay Conkle Roberts is, and Italy are going to know that themselves as well. And being able to move the target, you know, you see the spaces are there, and Louise was able to make use of that and dot over.
And Emma, is that the kind of play we want to see from Scotland and really set the tone early on?
I think we do need to, we have to catch Italy off guard, and I think that is what we're doing. So it is just them little tips. I think we've seen some humongous hits from the Italians, and that means some of the players are flying out the line, which means there's going to be a space. So them little tip-ons means that we're just getting that bit of gain line.
Well, Italy, they were really in it at the start, actually. Some really good defensive play from Scotland, which we can actually see now. If we just take a look at some of their play just earlier on. Emma, what did you make of this from Scotland?
Sorry.
Can you see okay? It was more just their defensive play. Scotland are actually, it's some really good stuff that we're seeing from them.
Yeah, no, absolutely. And I think what is so important is we got on that scoreboard early, and it really has given us that little edge, and we're just absolutely not accepting them coming through. So the few times that Italy have got into our 22, it's not a rollover for them to get a try.
And Lisa, better from Scotland?
Oh, massively better. I think you'd say over the past couple of games, maybe defensively, we've been on the back foot there. We've kind of let teams play. Whereas you're seeing here against Italy, we're actually taking the game to them and we're giving some more dominance in there. I mean, I think we can still continue and have more first up tackle dominance. You see the effects it does have. We can have more of them. Like Emma said, we really want to put Italy off the game, and defensively, that is how we'll be able to do that.
And it is a lot more promising because Italy are a very good team in the world rankings. They're fifth World Cup quarter finalists. It's been hard for Scotland in recent times. I mean, going back quite a while for the last victory, but we're starting to see glimmers.
Yeah, we are definitely starting to see glimmers, and it's all about now holding on to that. We, like you said, last year we went in 10-7 up, and unfortunately we let that lead slip. But I think now, look at the team we have here, I think definitely we can probably keep that lead going.
Yeah, absolutely. Italy have some real playmakers out there, and I think in terms of Rigoni and Dinka, like, they are linking up incredibly well for Italy, and I think if you can keep them quiet, we would look to put Italy under a lot of pressure.
Yeah. Now, the thing is, Emma, you actually know what it's like to score against Italy. I do have to say, so you've got 5 Scotland tries. 2 of those have come against Italy in the past 2 seasons. Almost half of your tries have been against this team. You know what it's like to score against them.
It is, and believe it or not, both them tries are from short range, quite similar to Louise McMillan, and obviously we got the rolling ball there as well. I would say they're lucky they're off the back of a team effort, but it is good to get them.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, we can actually, let's take a look at Italy now. Dinka, she is so dangerous, and we can see when Italy take that chance, Lisa.
Yeah, definitely. Like you said, at this point, Italy had really not had that much sustained pressure at all or possession. But, you know, a small mistake here, and Italy are literally pouncing on it. And you, again, it's showing the dangerousness of Dinka on the wing here. And she's really unlucky that, you know, we say it all the time, the bounce of the ball on rugby, it really does, you know, it can go either way. And she's really unlucky here, actually, to not get the try. But that, I think, definitely put a scare into Scotland. And actually, you know, Scotland of old, that probably could have scared us and we'd shy away. But actually, that moment there, I think, really gave Scotland a bit more of a boost of, like, here, we can't let this go. Let's step up another gear and not give these guys another chance in our 22.
And Emma, you know what it's like to play against that dangerous Italy side, don't you?
I do. And I think what has been really important, and I think you can see from the kicks that have been put in, it is territory for us. You can see some huge kicks. And when we are getting down in the right areas of the pitch, that is when we're performing. It's being careful around penalties and maybe giving that extra pass that's not needed, that is allowing Italy into play. They are a team that can play incredibly well unstructured, so, and that is normally the most difficult to defend off. And as you can see there, that was a very near try for Italy.
Yeah, as you say, unstructured, that just came out of nowhere and really could have done some damage. We're Scotland quite, I don't want to say lucky to get off there, but it was fortunate that Italy didn't get on the scoreboard at that time for them.
I think it definitely was, like you said, it would have been a massive momentum swing there in Italy's favour. And we know when Italy get momentum, they roll with it and they keep going and they add more and more pressure. And like Emma said, they will make the game as unstructured as possible because that is where they thrive. But like you said, we're lucky to get away with that there, and we used it again as a bit of motivation of like, we cannot give these guys anything, so any loose kicks, anything, we cannot give these guys it. And like Emma said, we are playing a territory game, and what I'd like to see them do a bit more is actually in this territory, let's have the ball hit the ground a bit more. We've seen the Italian 15 make a few mistakes. Let's put more pressure on her. Let's really make this an uncomfortable time for her.
Well, Italy did then get on the score sheet not long after. It was Franco here, Lisa. We can just take a look at the pictures now.
Yeah, it's off the back of a pretty solid set piece there. Jara Franco coming off the base of the scrum, and you know, is a pretty hard carrier to bring down. And then it just plays into Italy's power game here. It's just very tight, very much probably Emma Wassell's special, to be completely honest. Pick and goes, to be fair, Scotland defend it really, really well. First few phases, we can see we're getting nice and low, trying to get underneath, not give Italy an easy score here, but again, sustained pressure, and Jada manages to get herself over and over the line.
Emma, is this the Italy that you know?
Yeah, you know what? Italy, more of the tries we have seen from them would be your unstructured coming through the back. So actually, that is a more surprising try to see from Italy. I think the pick and goes that close line are incredibly difficult to defend, and I think it becomes a weight battle a little bit, but something which I think Scotland could use to their advantage is trying to hold that ball up over the line, because if they bring that ball over the line, hold it up, it means that we can kick out and get out of that area of the pitch.
Well, Italy did take the lead there. It was 7-5 at that point. Lana Skeldon, a player who Scotland just, she shines for Scotland. And here she is again, just before the half-time whistle. Lisa.
Yeah, so again, set piece has been really good. We've come back to them all. I think at this point, Italy's had a yellow card, so we're down one in the pack. And again, just this patience and ability to move them all around. And then just that sudden burst of pace, and Lana's over there. The amount of tries Lana has had off the back of them all is crazy, but it just, again, it shows the ability these guys have got when we're in the right areas, set pieces going well, we have that ability to score.
And, I mean, Lana is so strong. What is it like playing against her? That's the Lana that you know that we just saw there.
I think very, very promising to see that Mull try. I know that we can do so well, and Lana's on the end of that very often. She's very patient back there and experienced in what she's doing, but I think it is very important that we win that line out, and how tight everyone kind of stays together. You can see how fragmented Italy get, and then we just stay patient with it and results in a try.
Well, it's brilliant for Scotland to be in the lead at halftime. The crowd are totally behind this team. It is so loud here at the Dam Health Stadium. And another player who's cheering on this side is Rona Lloyd. She's speaking to our reporter, Andy Burke.
Yes, Rona, we've been watching you tearing it up for GB7s in the last few weeks. I know many fans would love to see you out there for Scotland today, but you're here cheering them on. What did you make of the first half performance?
Yeah, absolutely. If you can't be playing, you ought to be there super fanning, which I've very much been enjoying. And no, hugely positive first half. I think the Italian defence has been really strong, but we've been patient in attack. We've kept the ball. I think Helen Nelson, Lisa Thompson have been absolutely excellent in that open play kicking, and that's put Scotland in the right position to score tries.
How important was that try just before half-time, Lana Skeldon, just psychologically to go in the lead?
Oh, massively. The 2 5 minutes either end of the half-time are huge for that momentum shift. So to get a try on the board, if we can back up with a really strong first 5 minutes, I think we'll be in a really good place to see out this game.
Yeah, I mean, second halves have been a problem. So many times Scotland have been in games and not quite got over the line. What do you think Brian and his coaches will be saying to the players about this second half?
No, absolutely. I think the bonus this time is that we're not chasing the game. Actually, we need to take some confidence from being in the lead and having that control. So it's more of the same for me in the second half. Start strong and really see out that last 20 minutes.
Giving this crowd some more to cheer.
Oh, and yeah, the crowd have been amazing. They've been behind the girls every step of the way. And when you're on the pitch and you can hear everybody shouting in Scotland, it pushes you to give that extra inch. And I think we're going to see that out there.
Well, let's hope they get a victory to cheer. Thank you, Rona.
Absolutely, thank you.
Well, there is plenty more sport here on the BBC still to come. Tomorrow's Sports Scene is on at 7:15, featuring extended highlights of Aberdeen versus Rangers. Next Friday is live championship action from Dens Park at 7:30, as Dundee host Cove Rangers, also on the BBC Scotland channel. On Saturday, we have the Scottish Cup semi-final. That's Falkirk against Inverness Caledonian Thistle at 11:45 a.m. on BBC One Scotland. And also next Saturday, will be back here for Scotland versus Ireland in the final round of the Women's Six Nations from 7:15. And rounding the weekend off with extended highlights of Rangers versus Celtic in the Scottish Cup on Sports Scene at 7:15 here on BBC Scotland. Now, Emma, as we have you, can you just tell us a bit more about rehab, how it's going, and is there a timescale of when we'll get to see you back on the pitch?
Yeah, so I am looking at a 5 to 6 month return. We have the World XV tournament that will take place in October, so that is the aim. I will be doing everything in my power to get back to that. Crutches for a couple more weeks, unfortunately, but then hopefully I can build from there. I know it'll be a tough few months, but yeah, I'll be doing everything I can to get back on the pitch.
Now, watching from the stand today, what do you want to see in the second half from Scotland?
As Rona said, a wee bit more of the same. I think the territory is huge. You've seen them make mistakes, which have put us in the right positions of the pitch. And again, I would love to see some more mall tries. I'm not sure if everyone else would, but I wouldn't mind seeing a few more of those. But yeah, I think territory, keeping a hold of ball, and I do like that Scotland are trying to play freely, the offloads, and just really putting people into space.
And Lisa, from you?
Again, I'd like to see us continue playing as fast-paced a brand rugby as we can. We've seen we really can put Italy under pressure when we're playing quickly in those offload games. And again, defensively, let's get some more dominant tackles and put Italy off.
Absolutely. Well, let's get back to it. Here's our commentary team of Thomas Duncan and Heather Lockhart.
Welcome back. And it's a huge roar that greets Scotland as they return to the pitch. Although it won't be an ounce of complacency from them, given, as we've already mentioned, Italy came from 10-3 down in this fixture last year at half-time, so they know all too well how to turn things around in their favour. Scotland had 61% of possession in that first half, which is way more than they've had in any of the three games so far. And they are 40 minutes away from ending a run of 12 straight defeats and getting their first win of the championship, which will boost where they could finish in the standings, which is significant this year because we've got the WXV tournament coming in the autumn, launched by World Rugby, and they'll be split into tiers, and what tier you go into depends on where you finish in this championship, Heather.
Yeah, very much so. The top three go into tier one, the fourth place team go into tier two automatically, and the fifth place team from the Six Nations plays off with Spain to determine whether they go into this tier two or tier three, and the sixth place goes into tier three.
Well, Italy again making an unforced handling error, Auramuzzo this time. And remember, they are still down to 14 players for 5 minutes or so. Giordana Duca in the sin bin. And these are the sorts of things, Heather, that from a Scotland point of view, you need to capitalise on. Gifted field position.
Very much. You could see Christine Belaya there when they came onto the pitch, smiling, just like feeling that good energy. The crowd's really getting behind the teams here, and a brilliant opportunity field position-wise.
Set!
Scotland scrum. Can they launch a strike playoff? In the back of this one, McDonald. Thompson crashes up in the centre. Gallagher looks to get over the 22, does so. Bartlett, loose head prop. Scotland just edging ever closer. They go wide. Thompson tries to get the fend out. Mutso puts in a solid tackle. Here's Belial, puts the head down. Drives forward, tackle's called. McDonald is having to protect the ball. Nelson. Rachel Malcolm, the Scotland captain. Scotland are pinged at the ruck.
Yeah, Scotland would want to cut out the unforced errors there and just keep the penalty count down, and just keep building in terms of possession and convert that possession into tries. Four tries gives them a bonus point instead of 4 points, so it'd be 5 points for a win on the competition points table.
Yeah, just move. Yeah. Thank you.
Jade Conkle-Roberts made 53 metres in that first half. Incredible.
Yeah, quite a few players over 50 metres taking their opportunities. But yeah, work rate from Jake Conkle-Roberts has been outstanding so far.
Yeah, it's only her second game back from an ankle injury. We'll see how long she can last. 47 minutes last week. See if we can get the full 80 out of her. This afternoon, Italy set up the mall. Federighi has it, passes it back. Goes to Deck.
Yeah.
Stefan. Mutso off her wing. Makes a few metres.
Knock on.
And it's yet another knock on from Italy.
Yeah, I think it's a bit of both. I think Scotland are putting them under pressure. I think they're looking lively, they're ready. Two in at the tackle. Just...
it's hard to see there, but... Saura Mutso. Scotland's a bit further back than they had a few minutes ago, but another scrum and a chance to get on the front foot. These handling errors from an Italian point of view are killing them. They managed to win the game despite a mountain of handling errors last week. Can Scotland punish them better than Ireland did? Smith, strong run from the centre. Bartlett, Belial. Skeldon, the front row, moving the ball to Rowley at full-back. McDonald, Bartlett again, Malcolm, Gallagher, it's loose.
Fall on the
Federighi.
Ball. Number four.
Federighi was in there, but Italy are penalised. And we mentioned right at the start of the game, Heather, 10 penalties against them at the Ruck against Ireland last week, and they've been ill-disciplined in that area again.
Yeah, just off her feet, diving on the ball. But Scotland there getting some change out of just some shorter passes, some good interplay there by the front row, Belial and Skeldon. I think don't force it out wide too early.
There's Jordana Duca back on from her 10 minutes on the naughty step, which eventually led to that second Scotland try from Lana Skeldon just before the break. And Italy haven't really got out their own half in the opening 5 minutes of this second half.
Scotland just need to keep patient.
Nelson doesn't find touch. A let off for Italy. And now the visitors will try to exit. And Stefan's charged down. McLaughlin snaffles Madia as she produces a salvage job for Italy.
Second turnover by Smith there, excellent play.
Scotland have the ball in their grasp again. Skeldon. McDonald, quick ball. Conkle-Roberts. Scotland just trying to play quickly, and Italy get in the way and they are penalised. Scotland advantage.
That goal, Willis!
McMillan. Scotland 4 metres out. A third try would be a huge boost so early in this second period. Skeldon will go for it again. She's still on her feet, Lana Skeldon. Still she goes.
Yeah.
Conkle-Roberts twists. Scotland so close. Second advantage, says the referee. Will Scotland try something here? Nelson, Thompson, can't she get to the line? So close from Lisa Thompson. Ball is slow for Scotland. They go for it. Try given. Bartlett's over. Yes. Pats on the head, hugs from our teammates. The prop is the one who squeezes over the try line to extend Scotland's advantage at the start of the second half. And again, it's patience that pays off for Scotland.
Forwards working hard, reorganising, getting off the deck. Look at that, Louise and Leah Bartlett just taking their time. Brilliant finish, second try for Leah Bartlett for Scotland.
The forwards have definitely done their job so far. Three tries. And Helen Nelson try to land her first successful kick of the afternoon, which she does with aplomb. Scotland's lead is 10 points. And when you've been on the kind of run of form that Scotland have, 12 straight defeats, this is such a confidence booster.
Sarah Law there just giving her some advice, bringing on the tea part of the squad and playing her part and helping her vice-captain get that conversion on her 50th cap.
Well, what have Italy got in response? You have to say they've been out of sorts so far. Lots of handling errors, the line-out's not functioned. But they are a quality side. And when it clicks, as it did for three tries against Ireland last week, it can be fireworks. Scotland secure the restart.
Stay back, stay back. Back on the ball.
McDonald's box kick, claimed by her opposite number, Stefan. Here's try scorer Giada Franco. Bumps off one tackle. Nelson goes low and brings her down. Madia kicks straight to Rowley. He's going to have a little look here. Lovely step, Corey Rowley. Still going the fullback. Bartlett on to Malcolm, the captain.
Stop, 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 stop.
Nelson clears. Here's Madia. Puts the ball into the Edinburgh sky, but it's straight down Nelson's throat. A fly half up to the 10-metre line. It's Conkle Roberts. Always makes metres every time she gets on the ball. Skeldon. Thompson under some pressure, and that's a slightly late challenge from Sara Tunesi. Italy have the ball. Ostuni Minuzzi, she's broken one tackle. Madia.
Tackle!
Delisle doing her defensive duties. Rigoni. Sileri. And it's another knock-on from Stefan. Scrum Scotland, and Italy just can't get going.
Yeah, it was a good take by Ostuni Minuzzi from the kick. Great kick by... Yeah,
the TMO will surely have a look at that. It was a bit high.
Yeah. TMO, so we...
Let's have a listen.
Check. Yeah. A possible foul play by Blue. It's a late contact after the kick. Yeah.
So Sara Tunesi,
okay,
who put in a couple of thumping hits in the first half, she is ferocious in defence, but she was a bit too keen to close down that kick from Lisa Thompson. And the TMO, who is Ian Tempest of the RFU, is going to play the footage for the referee, Aurélie Guazelot. And you would think, Heather, it will probably be a penalty at least for Scotland.
I will get you real speed as well, Aurélie, and we'll look at the angles we have, and wide, and in real speed.
Do you have another angle?
I will get you more angles. I'll keep playing angles for you so you see.
They're just trying to get all the angles sorted for the referee to have a look at.
For me live, my feeling is play on, because I saw clearly the arm to go for the door.
The referee's intimating there what she saw in real time was a fair challenge for the ball. She just doesn't quite get there, but it's maybe the shoulder.
Orally, I'm trying to get your angles. For me,
Lisa,
she's
Thompson.
Not charging the ball, and she's not realistically looking to charge the ball and
yeah,
charges the
so
kicker.
Please show me. Okay, where is the contact? Is on the shoulder. So it's just late, maybe PK only.
Yes, Orly, I can go with that. There's no head contact, but it's
yeah.
a late charge on the kicker.
It just late. It's penalty only. Okay. So where is the point of restart? Where the ball is? No.
So it's going to be a penalty to Scotland.
Penalty
no more,
contact,
no head contact.
No,
if there was head contact, you start at red and then
no
look to if there's any mitigation to go down to yellow
the
or penalty.
No. Donc, elle est juste en
the referee
retard,
is explaining
danger,
to Rachel Malcolm no head contact, so it will be a penalty only to Scotland.
Oh.
Correct decision, Heather.
Head contact.
Yeah, I think she got her timing wrong, but she's saying there was no head contact, so we'll go. That's the referee's decision, but yeah. Bit late, definitely. Definite penalty, if not potential yellow, but penalty for now.
Helen Nelson nudges Scotland into a very promising position here as they look to add to their yeah. healthy 10-point advantage. They've made a really good start to this second half, and you can see 70% of the ball. Italy not helping themselves with a couple of knock-ons. Another line-out goes to plan for Scotland. McLaughlin takes it cleanly, and Skeldon will fancy her chances again. Here go the Scotland forwards.
Seven out.
They've been in fine form at the Damhill Stadium. Bartlett fancies another. She's over the line. Can she get it down? Try! Scotland's dominance up front. And Leah Bartlett once again takes the acclaim of her teammates. What a start to this second half.
That line-out is working so well. Skeldon hitting, Rachel McLaughlin at the tail. And just reorganisation. Leah Bartlett does it down for her second try. But look at the work rate in there. Look at the faces. Rachel, Christine Belisle, Louise McMillan, Jay Conkle-Roberts, all doing their bit.
A smile for Leah Bartlett. Surprised Lana Skeldon let her have that one, but a team effort, as these mug tries always are. Helen Nelson with another conversion attempt. Scotland claim a bonus point try. Beautiful strike from Helen Nelson, and Scotland are 24-7 in front. And Heather, this is a position they've not found themselves in too often, and they have struggled to close out games at times. What do they need to focus on for this final half hour or so?
There's definitely a different aura about them today, just super organised, they've got the momentum, everyone knows their role, there's clarity, there's good kicking for territory, and there's patience. But never underestimate Italy, they're on four competition points, and they'll be looking to get as much from this game as they possibly can.
Yeah, Scotland have been very efficient, businesslike so far. Nelson tries to find space, McGee can't gather. Backwards, but penalty Italy. Sillery's in there again. And that's exactly the tonic they needed to try and turn this game around.
She's like an extra back row at the breakdown. Just her timing and her understanding of the game is superb.
clamped herself onto that rock and tries, they might. Scotland couldn't move. Michaela Sealery.
78 cap today, just showing all her experience in that little moment there.
And talking of experience, Sara Baratina is on for her 115th cap, but it's loose and Scotland claim it. Dial maybe should have held on to that, but it's still in Scotland hands.
Tackle! No hand, no hand, stay back.
Malcolm. Scotland trying to just set this up to clear their lines, which they do. Here's Dinka. Barely seen her since that missed opportunity in the first half.
Advantage. Knock on in the tackle. Knock on. Advantage. Temple happy with that.
Italy playing with knock on advantage. Here's Baratin.
Yeah, thank you.
Regoni bumps off Grant with ease. And she's up to the 22.
Yes! No.
Madia.
Advantage over.
Sileri, Giada Franco. Italy want quick ball, but they've not got it. Baratin. Here's Dinka. Ostuni Manuzzi, got space on the outside. Vittorio Ostuni Manuzzi eventually put down. Madia. Maurice. McMillan tries to get herself out of there. Baratin. Good offload. Duca. Chance for Italy. Madia. Sileri steps back inside. Frantic defence from Scotland. Tunesi. Can't get turned to try and present that ball cleanly. Baratin gets it away. Rigoni trucks it up. 5 metres out, Italy. As they look to find a response in this game. They've been nowhere in this second half so far. Duca.
We have advantage.
Penalty advantage. Here goes Tunesi. It's a team effort to prevent her crossing the line for Scotland. But Italy are over. Tunesi gets another go, spins, and grounds the ball cleanly. Fantastic response from the Italians.
Powerful, powerful play. Great spin and excellent finish. Scored against England as well. Second try of the championships for her.
Is there a question whether there's a tackle completed there or not, Heather? I'm not sure. I think that's what Evie Gallagher's pointing to.
Yeah.
And Michaela Sileri will try and get Italy back to within 10 points. Expertly done by the Italian centre. And they certainly enjoyed that one, and it's game on again, Heather.
Very much so. I think Baratin was just showing her composure and her experience just at the breakdown there, getting the penalty advantage and Tunisia scoring. But Baratin, watch out for her the last 20 minutes.
Well, Scotland, just when they thought they'd nudged clear Italy of hold them back, still a good advantage. And Katie Mathinson is on at scrum half with Mary McDonald. Done her work, and Chloe Rowley just let that bounce. Another handoff, just Duca sat down.
Some excellent play from Mary McDonald, well done.
A very solid first start of the championships for her. It's a loose pass, and Gallagher mops up. Mathinson. Belial. Another power of work from Scotland's front row, and Italy straight in there. Hedrighi, and they go quickly. Baratin. Here's Locatelli striding away towards the posts. Rowley scrambles back. The ball was loose.
Knock on.
And it is a knock on. Crucial intervention from Chloe Rowley to prevent Isabella Locatelli from going under the sticks.
Baratin just showing there's the gap. Fantastic offload. Locatelli doing well. But Chloe Rowley equally industrious in defence there.
I speak to it. Yeah, Rachel, just be careful on the floor. Don't clap the player.
Again, Heather, the impact of
number eight.
Sarah Baratin, quick tap penalty, and off they go. The experience, Italy's most capped player. Sarah T comes on in the front row.
Yeah, Italy don't kick so much. The quick taps, that's the way to get there. Locatelli just showing her awareness with Baratin to get on her shoulder to get the offload from her.
Scrums have been solid for both teams. Baratin just rallying the troops at scrum time. This is a big one. As we enter the final quarter of this match, Scotland 20 minutes from a first win of the Six Nations. It's there for Mattinson. Thompson clears. Minuzzi, good first touch. Ostuni Minuzzi weaving away past purple jerseys. Vittorio Ostuni Minuzzi for the line. Vicini gets the offload. Vicini goes under the sticks. And that is what Italy are capable of. They don't need much ball, but give them opportunity in broken field, and they are lethal.
Ostuni Minuzzi just showing fantastic footballing skill there. Didn't work out in the first half, but look at her mettle. Here's a response. Broken play, and Bikini doing the hooker, doing absolutely superbly well to get on for the offload to finish. Great still, great control, great eye for the gap.
It's all about the forwards scoring the tries this afternoon, but the fullback set that one up. Sillari tried to make it a three-point game. Simple enough for her. And Scotland have been pegged right back here at the Damhill Stadium. Vittoria Vecchini, she's had her struggles at the line out the hooker, but fantastic support line there.
Seven. Really, really good.
And what a final, finale, I should say, we have here is Ranuccini. Lisa Ranuccini is on in the back row for Isabella Locatelli, who's grimacing there, taking a sore one. This is where Scotland's nerve will be tested. Lisa Thompson hoist this into the Italian half. It's claimed cleanly this time by Stefan. Scotland will try and force the kind of errors we have seen from Italy in their own half. Tunisi, she's been fantastic. Madia, Buka, Baratin, what a difference she's made since coming on. Thought she maybe was going to retire after the World Cup, but just keeps going. Tunisi, Scotland trying to hold her up, the maul is called. And Scotland have the turnover. Excellent work by the pack of forwards.
These moments are absolutely huge. We saw it in the first half, and there it is again in the second half. Moments to be celebrated, how hard the forwards are working to get that.
Time off.
Brian Eason watches on. Desperate for that first win.
Time on.
I think Scotland and Italy both have got to play with composure in the last few minutes rather than any desperation. I think it's an opportunity, and I think they need to play with that performance mindset.
And Scotland will feel they haven't done an awful lot wrong since they scored their fourth try, but Italy have just come roaring back to really good tries of their own.
Set!
Scrum is solid once more for Scotland. Martinson, and it's wide, and here's a chance for Fran McGee to stretch her legs. The winger surging up to the 22.
No, stand back.
Smith, Gallagher. Italy doing the worm there to Nisi to try and get herself out the way of that ruck and avoid being penalised. Here's Nelson, Smith, there's space out wide for Scotland. Thompson tries to pop onto Rowley, now there's a kick through here, and it's being chased all the way by Sophia Stephan. Meryl Smith's back, and Smith is going to do the dirty work. It's Kareem Grant, I beg your pardon, who's back and gets on the ball.
Time off. Yes. Check.
And Scotland again just guilty of trying to force that in the wide channels.
Live. I'm not sure. So, okay, it's a possible head-to-head.
Possible head-to-head collision here is going to be checked.
Orly, I'm going to show you it in real speed, and then we will slow it down to establish points of contact for
I'm,
you.
I'm ready.
Okay, the angles will roll now.
Let's have a look. Jade Conkle-Roberts,
so
who carries
on. Point of contact when we have the best under.
Yes, I will freeze points of contact on that last angle for you. This is our best angle for points of contact. I will freeze it on points of contact.
Sarah Sey, the replacement on Jade Conkle-Roberts. And is
just
that
before?
Contact with the head?
It is shoulder direct on the head.
Agreed.
Okay, for me, it's full play because player 18 is upright. It's a high degree of danger, no mitigation for me.
It's going to be a red card here.
For anyone disagree with that?
I don't think there is.
No, nothing. Okay. Tempo.
Orly, I agree with you. 18 is hitting forward into the tackle.
Yeah.
Always upright, high danger, no mitigation.
Yeah, she's in
I
trouble here.
I speak French for captain, and I speak with you. We have penalty here for you.
Can hear
donc,
the logic.
Est droite. Il y a directement l'épaule dans la tête, donc ça sera carton rouge.
Yeah, red card. If your French is any good.
Wait. Yeah.
You can hear them
direct head contact, no mitigation.
Yeah, it's very clear. Those tackles are just completely unacceptable in rugby these days. It's difficult for players, but you just simply have to get lower there.
Yeah, Joy Neville was just checking, did you think she stepped, any mitigation, but no. Aurélie Groslow said no, and so it's a red card.
Sarah Sey, who's barely been on the pitch, is off, and that hands Scotland the advantage, both in territory and in numbers, for the final 15 minutes of this game, and they simply have to take advantage. What a chance for Scotland. Skeldon throws in, finds Eva Donaldson, who's on from the replacements bench. Martinson has ball, Smith, that first receiver, Nelson, here's McGee, who made that searing break.
Okay. No advantage,
moments
no
ago.
We come back.
Scotland have the advantage.
8, side entry.
It's Jada Franco in at the side of the ruck. The ball.
No.
And Heather.
Your entry is not good.
Scotland will be licking their lips at the prospect of a maul here.
Yeah.
Very much so. It's been working. The tries have been received from Matt, and Eva Donson took a good line out there before, so process is here.
On five.
Here we go then. It's sacked. Straight to deck.
On the proper, play on.
Scotland halted. Belisle pushed backwards. Skeldon. And it will be about patience for Scotland if they want to cross the whitewash. Here they go. Just a couple of metres out. Bartlett was on a hat trick. Here they go. Scotland recycle again.
Stay back. 10. Offside. 10.
Can they edge over? Martinson spots space. Goes wide. Yeah. Smith steps back inside. Looks to dive over. She's just short. Just short. Scotland have numbers. It's held up. Fantastic scramble defence from Italy.
Time off. No, time is off.
Eddie Martinson just getting a bit excited there. Time off calls the referee.
Il y a d'abord le maul tout à l'heure. Et là, il y a un hors-jeu, deux hors-jeux consécutifs, d'accord? Donc de la discipline. So, two infringement on this situation, two offside. Two options, yeah. On here, two offside.
Can I just ask a question about the number of penalties in this area? Are they on another warning?
Yes, no, just
another
now.
Warning.
Yes, just
perfect.
Now.
I decided to see, I didn't see
just
the
now. Two options.
So Malcolm, just
two
double
options.
Checking,
yeah.
Are you doing your job?
It's 21
says yes,
here offside.
Of course, we've been warned, two infringements for offside.
Yeah.
And another one, and Italy will potentially go down to 13 players.
Yeah.
And Scotland will
time
reset off. And go again, and if they could score
time
here.
Time on. Time
would
on.
Not be curtains for Italy, but it would give them a mountain to climb. Skeldon throws in. Donaldson on it again. And here they go, Scotland.
So
halted for now. Skeldon has it. The momentum's with them. Skeldon's over for a second try. And could that be the one that gets them over the line for the first time in this Six Nations? A precious victory is edging closer. And Lana Skeldon adds another try to her name.
That driving line-out maul is such a weapon. Great take by Eva Donaldson at the back of the line-out. And look what it means to Lana and the whole pack and everyone supporting here for Scotland.
It has been clinical from Scotland's when they've got in positions to put Italy under pressure. It's what they've struggled with in a lot of recent matches, but the forwards have stayed patient and done the business, and Lana Skeldon is a prolific try scorer and ball holder as well. That one's just drifted wide from Helen Nelson. Italy, 8 points behind, but a player down. They will not give in, and we've already seen what they're capable of. If you give them some space, Scotland have them where they want them as we enter the final 11 minutes. Elisa Dinka is off, Francesca Gransotto is on.
Use the ball!
And it's probably a testament to Scotland, Heather, that we've not seen much from Elisa Dinkas here. Fran McGee again makes yard. Justine Minuzzi's in trying to pilfer possession. Scotland secure it though. Malcolm. Gallagher.
Tackle!
Caught by Ranuccini. Nelson. Smith, pass out to Chloe Rowley, looks up, tries to go inside Rigoni, Stefan with the cover tackle, but Scotland are up to the 22.
No. Ball is off, play on, ball is
ball was out, it's play on here, Merrill Smith. That's Kareem, it's Merrill Smith.
Release them!
Turned and forced to go all the way back.
Use it!
Scotland just making sure everything's in place before Katie Mattinson puts this up, which she does, needs to stay in play. Madia secures ball for Italy. They need something special. Baratin. Mattinson. And she's put that out in the full. And that could be a costly error from Scotland.
13.
Katie Mattinson apologises, but she knows. She just switched off for a second there.
Baratin just like directing the traffic there, just testing if they are still everything to play for with 10 minutes to go.
Emma Stevanin, the young back, is on for Italy. Michaela Sillery is off, which is interesting given how important a player she is.
No clear gap. No. Yeah, no clear gap, okay? They're coming.
Here, please. Scotland was alone, not happy with the gap.
Scotland be looking to pressurise as much as possible here.
Knock on advantage.
Scotland have knocked on in attempting to steal this line out. Italy have an advantage. Or they'll go back for the scrum if not.
Advantage for knock on.
Baratin. Stefan, who I think shifted out to the wing from scrum half. She did play there against England.
Advantage off of von Lockham.
And here come Italy, Rigoni. Ostuni Minuzzi set up one try already. Threatened to break into space there again. Baratin. Stevanin. Madia. Maurice, is that forward? That certainly is from Tunisia.
And second.
And Scotland's survive. And you can see the pain on Tunisia's face, just trying to force it. It's the position they're in. They need to create something.
Time off.
Everyone just working so hard in these final few minutes. But again, it's patience from both sides. Both sides just... it's the defence as much as the attack. The attack just forcing things, but the defence forcing those errors to a large degree.
Christine Belisle is receiving some treatment. The Scotland prop, power of work she's put in. And you can see Scotland's with the bulk of the ball, the carries, the game line success. Front foot rugby in essence.
I think that's been really, really key today. I think the kicking of Helen Nelson and Lisa Thompson has been super key, especially in the first half. And I think the line-out maul in the second half has really taken off. It's been much cleaner ball. First half line-out wasn't so clean, but it's made such a difference to the driving maul and finishing it off.
Kasagi, Elise Kasagi is on for Valeria Federighi for Italy in the second row. His royalty going to witness a Scotland victory here at the Damhill Stadium.
Well, it's not often two tries for the number two and two tries for the number one. With Lee McMillan there.
You would say that, Heather, in front rows union.
Absolutely.
Set!
Big scrum for Scotland and Italy. Can they force a penalty? But it's very solid from Scotland. It's turning. And it's Scotland who get the penalty. And look at what it means.
Number one.
The steely determination on Rachel Malcolm's face.
She celebrated the win and then she immediately was like, calm, calm. She knows there's still some rugby to play, but huge celebration, huge team effort there.
Plenty of work for Scotland still to do. Italy up to double figures for penalties. It has been a problem for them. Scotland with
Richard,
one of the better disciplinary records, actually the best, before a ball was kicked in this round. Skeldon, the line-out's been great all afternoon, and Donaldson has come on and seamlessly added to that. Patience from Scotland. Pattinson.
No. Play on.
Play on, says the referees. Bikini wins the turnover. The hooker. That's great work. And now a penalty for Italy. And that's how momentum can swing. Rigoni wants to get on with this. And she's booted Italy up to the 22.
Superb kick by Rigoni. Never count her out at whatever stage of the match it is.
And Heather, I'll get you to name a player of a match in a moment. And Scotland get the benefit of a loose throw, but Belial couldn't gather. And
scrum.
It will be a scrum to Italy. Well, Heather, what about that player of the match?
Yeah, I think there's definitely, I was talking about the kicking, Helen Nelson, Lisa Thompson, but I think very much forward effort today in terms of try scored. Lana Skeldon getting two, Leah Bartlett two, Louise McMillan one to date. But I think player of the match is Jade Conkle-Roberts on 19 carries, 95 metres, second match after her return from injury.
She is a totem wherever she plays, second row today, back row more often than not. Pivotal that Scotland have her back, and she has made a huge difference, but there is work to do. Italy always threatening with ball in hand, and what a shove from Scotland, and they get the penalty again. Their dominance paying off.
Absolutely phenomenal. That front row have placed in 76 minutes, 76 and a half minutes, and they've produced that. That's just absolutely phenomenal. Belial, Skeldon and Bartlett, outstanding.
And it's not often the front row last the full game either. Sensational work, and there is Jade Conkle-Roberts, the TikTok player of the match.
19.
More carries than anyone on the pitch. I think she'd obviously gone off for an HIA or blood replacement, and she's back on for Donaldson, who, Heather, was excellent in her brief spell on the park, especially at the line-out.
Yeah, University of Edinburgh, and played in the Celtic Challenge, and I think really benefited from those extra games, just showing her accuracy and efficiency in the line-out.
Not straight.
And it squints.
Not straight.
And Italy.
Not straight.
Well, they need two scores, Italy, 8 points behind. 2.5 minutes to play. So every second that ticks by is fantastic from a Scotland point of view, but Italy will have ball here from the scrum.
No,
the line out. Bikini. Short. Italy will play.
Tackle!
Can they produce a bit of magic to set up a grandstand finish? Here's Rigoni. Ostini Minuzzi has been a threat with ball in hand. Granzotto put the kick in. And Scotland will be forced to defend in their own 22, but they'll take that. Their line-out's been solid all afternoon. And we only have a minute and a half left. And Scotland are looking good for a first win, a bonus point win of this Six Nations.
Scotland are still talking, still communicating.
Play on!
It was a strange decision for Italy to put boot to ball there. thought they would try and
not straight.
Recycle.
It's outside on your shoulder. It's not straight.
No. Another one's called not straight.
I'm sorry.
They had too many in the line out.
I don't see that, sorry. Just for me, it's not straight.
Baratine knows it.
You saw him catch that. It's sagging.
I understand.
Italy's still playing for even a losing bonus point as well.
Absolutely. And what can they come up with here? It's turned over. Martinson
yes,
has it. Is she going to be driven into touch?
No,
she
advantage,
is.
No advantage, knock on.
But it is
knock on.
A knock-on by Italy. Scotland scrum. And the victory header is going to be theirs.
Just finish the job first.
Getting ahead of myself. The crowd getting behind their players. This will be huge for this group of players. They've been on a miserable run, but it's finally going to be victory for Scotland, surely now. If they can just secure this scrum and get it off the park, they will have the 5 points. Players getting a bit excited in the front row there. Skeldon.
Nine, straight.
Two tries, Bartlett, two tries. Louise McMillan as well on the score sheet for Scotland.
Five.
Here we go.
Set.
Can Italy force Scotland back, get a penalty, anything to try and get the losing bonus point? It's back, it's off the pitch. It's victory for Scotland. And all the frustration, all the pain of the last 12 games evaporates here at the Damhill Stadium. They've worked so hard for it. Five tries, all coming from the heft of the forwards. Two for Bartlett, two for Skeldon, one for Louise McMillan, and look what it means to the players.
What a turnaround. One Sunday, a loss 55-0 to France. 6 days later, beating Italy at the Damhill, 29-21. Superb. Italy, fantastic opponents, and they'll be back.
They will be back. They'll look to end strongly against Wales at home next week. But this is Scotland's day. What an afternoon for them at the Damhill. It's finished Scotland 29, Italy 21.
Wow. Lisa, what a brilliant victory for Scotland. We're standing right in front of the celebrations. It is fantastic to see.
Oh yeah, you can see the emotions in the girls' faces. Like you said, it's been a long time overdue, and just the way they showed composure in that second half, went in with the lead and they kept that lead. Even though Italy, you know, they just wouldn't go away, Scotland just kept at it. And, you know, leaving with a five, like a try bonus point victory is fantastic.
It is absolutely amazing. We actually just saw Helen Nelson on the screen there. What a way to mark her 50th cap.
Oh, definitely. It's the way you want to have a 50th cap. You want to go out and you want to get a win, get a victory and play pretty darn well as well. And I think it definitely will be one for her to remember. And, you know, she's become one of the leaders of this team. And you saw that today in the way she's played, the composure, you know, kicking from hand and the way she played territory. You know, she's turned into such an integral part of the Scotland team now.
And the thing is, I don't know if you can hear it at home, but actually before the match, the Scotland players speak about playing here at the Damhill Stadium, and when Loch Lomond plays, Loch Lomond's playing again, and they're absolutely loving it. The fans behind us are all on their feet. It is brilliant to see.
Such a fantastic atmosphere. You know, these fans have been behind Scotland all the way through the good times and the bad times, and to give these fans something to cheer about and something to sing is amazing. And you know, that squad out there have really, really deserved that victory. A long time coming, but have deserved it, and one that's going to hopefully give them momentum to get another one next week.
And what a turnaround from last week. It wasn't looking good. Now we can barely hear each other talk.
Yeah, last week was a difficult day. It was a difficult day in the jersey, and I think we were very much humbled against France. But, you know, the forwards really stepped up today. I mean, all tries were scored by forwards today, and they really took the game by the scruff of the neck and just had total dominance over Italy. Set piece was fantastic, gave that platform that backs want to run from, and just, you know, like I say, they just added completely different fire in their belly today.
Yeah, absolutely. And then, I mean, that's the thing, you can see it now, you can hear it now. But let's actually hand over to our reporter, Andy Burke, who's with player of the match, Jade Conkle-Roberts.
Jade, you and your team have waited an awful long time for this moment. Tell us how it feels.
It just feels so surreal, like I can't quite believe it yet, but what a shift from our team. Absolutely incredible. The whole team, we prepped really strongly this week and we just had belief that entire week, and I think everybody showed that out there today.
You engineered a great position to take the victory, but you had to withstand a bit of a fight back there, didn't you, from Italy?
Wouldn't be Scottish if we didn't, would it?
But you really stood up in those moments.
Yeah, like, Italy, hats out, they're always so, so difficult to play against. They're physical, they bring an offload game, so credit to them for really coming out hard, and they made us play for that full 80. But I cannot be any more prouder than our team. I think we fought, and it's our time, and I think we're ready.
You've made these fans very happy today, Jade.
massive thank you to the fans for coming out. It would not be the same without you guys. The noise is just incredible.
Well, Jade, congratulations. You are the player of the match. Fantastic performance. Well done.
Thank you so much.
Wow. What an emotional match for Scotland. A brilliant start to the second half. Leah Bartlett extending the lead to 10 points just 7 minutes in. And then Bartlett again just 5 minutes later. But it wasn't long before Italy came a knocking. Sarah Tennessy this time. And again for Scotland, Lana Skeldon extending that lead, and Scotland with the win. Lisa, we actually heard Jade Conkle-Roberts there. It was quite emotional, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was quite emotional. I mean, it's when you don't win very often, when the wins come around, it is a very emotional time, especially when they're at home games. And you can see the way that Jade speaks, she's so passionate about playing for her country and playing with the squad here. And yeah, that emotion is a good thing. And we used it today in a very positive way, and I actually used it to drive our performance rather than hinder us.
And then you can see in the players too, it's really quite amazing. It's quite interesting though, because Italy are really still very strong in attack, which we saw in points. Although, let's actually hear from Rachel Malcolm, the captain. She's with our reporter, Andy Burke.
Rachel, you've got a smile on your face. I think it might be there for some time, some of your emotions.
I think the overwhelming one's relief at the minute. If I'm honest, this last year's been hell in a lot of ways for our group. We've gone through some really tough times, and you know, this group stuck together through thick and thin, and you know, we knew this win was coming and not many people believed in us. We kept believing, and that performance was one of the most complete performances we've done as a squad. You know, we stuck in it, we never kind of gave up in those moments where Italy got a nudge and they got a try. The mindset was there and that belief was there, and now that we've got this win, we just push on and keep going.
You mentioned the tough times and so many late in the day heartbreak moments across those defeats. Did you always feel today that you had it, that you weren't going to let it slip?
Yeah, 100%. You know, I think we've proven in a number of games this championship and glimpses how well we can play. And we talked this week about just seizing the day and seizing every moment, every opportunity today, and never stopping believing and just doing rather than talking. And I think we showed that today. And, you know, this group's something special. Not many teams can go through what we've been through and stick together and, you know, never have a crossword and always give 110% and always show up. And that's exactly what they've done, and that's why they got the result today. You know, now we push on, we've got a massive game next week, and I can't wait to get back out there. And the fans today, like, oh my goodness, it was like having another person on the pitch with us. I can't thank them enough for how much they got behind us. It was so good to get back here, and honestly, they made it so worth it.
Brilliant stuff, Rachel. Well done.
Thank you very much.
Some really good honesty from Rachel there. She was talking about it being a hellish year, and it has been really difficult, but again, just so honest there and where they are now.
Yeah, I think it shows volumes that, you know, Rachel could be so honest. And yeah, this squad has had a really tough time of it, both on and off the field. And like we said, to come out the other side and still have that fight, still have that desire, should be utterly applauded. And, you know, I think it just shows the character within that squad and the togetherness they have as a unit. You know, the girls who were playing, the girls who are on the bench, the girls who you know, are making up the wider squad. I think it's a massive squad effort, and you can see how much they want to play and win for each other.
And still having that belief, because it must have been tough over the past year. You can't. I mean, that must have been such a difficult situation to be in.
Yeah, I think it's a massively difficult situation to be in, and I think that belief is what drives and gets them through. And you can see it just added to that game, and like Rachel said, it just drove them through. And we want that to be the momentum swing now, where it's now, instead of we're talking about 12 losses in a row, we're talking about 12 victories in a row now.
Fingers crossed. Well, we are now joined by the Scotland head coach, Brian Eason. Brian, how does it feel to be talking about a win?
I don't know if I can say much on TV because I might swear. But
swear.
No, I wouldn't. It feels brilliant. It generally does. It more for these players have worked so hard. They generally have worked really hard over the last few weeks. And, you know, we've had some difficult games. There's been some really tight ones. And, you know, when we got our noses in front, we really wanted to squeeze them. It got a little bit worrying in the middle. But I thought they showed a little bit better composure when they got ahead, and once we got composure into the game, I thought we certainly deserved that win.
And much better today, especially after last weekend's defeat. That must have been really tough to take in such a tight turnaround, but it looks like a completely different team.
Yeah, look, this week's been, we were kind of forced around it. It's a 6-day turnaround, being in France and then travelling back, so this week has been around recovery and just getting our heads right. Rachel and Helen Nelson have worked really hard behind the scenes just on getting that mindset right, understanding around exactly how we wanted to play the game, get real clarity. And as I say, once we got a little bit of composure in that middle third especially, we certainly looked dangerous, and when we got into that bottom third, we were really pleased in terms of our conversion rate down there.
You must be really proud of your forwards as well today.
Yeah, like the forwards, I thought they mauled them really well. There was a couple of chances we probably could have taken a little bit earlier. We went 5-man instead of going 6+1, but you look, that's little things that we talked about at half-time. I thought Jade Conkle, the number 4 in her back, you know, I thought she carried particularly well, and, you know, some of that maul play as well was excellent. I said to Jade after that, you know, the thing is that number 4 stuck in her back now. She's worried about that.
Is that where we're going to see her now?
Look, I thought she was outstanding. She gives us that extra ball carrying in between the 250-metre channel. So, you look, I thought they were brilliant, but I thought the forwards outstanding, the scrummaging at the end as well, and you know, a lot of them played 80 minutes as well. That front row played 80 minutes, so well played to them.
How impressed are you with the way that we've turned around the set piece? I know last week was a little bit of a stumbling block against France, but today it was that was the thing that actually got us going. I mean, the amount of tries we got obviously off the back of the Lamal. How impressed are you with the turnaround the forwards have done, especially at
line-out time? Yeah, I think the forwards have been brilliant. And look, it's an interesting one. You say, you know, how much work we've done. We've not done much at all. We've had one session this week. I think it's just been, there's been a lot of work, homework done on computer, some analysis. Our analysts have done a great job in terms of looking at what we saw with the Italians. The Italian line-out's not been great through the championship, so we knew it was something we could go after. And at half-time, we said, look, we've mauled them really well first half. Let's keep at it. And you know, you're right, Lisa. I think they really put it together, and I was really proud of the forwards.
We did see those moments of kind of dangerous attack from Italy kind of all over the park at moments that you didn't even expect from them, but credit to your team for holding them back.
Yeah, well, we did kind of expect it there. Like the France's little sister, they like to play exactly like the same way that they do, you know, kind of Gaelic flair around. They like to play. We knew that when they were kind of 12 points down, they would go at us from everywhere. We had to tighten up a little bit. We're really disappointed, obviously, from the try that they scored from a poor kick chase. But look, that's something that we will fix for next week. But you know, we knew what to expect. I thought defensively we soaked them up, and then we got our just rewards at the end.
Talking about next week, what are you looking to take from this game moving into the Ireland game next week especially?
Look, I think set piece wise, you know, I think it's something that Ireland probably have been, you know, half decent at, and it's something that we can really go after. But look, if we can get the platform that the forwards have shown us, I think we've also shown that we've got some really talented backs out there as well. We actually said to our backs today that, you know, we want to go through them through the middle. We actually want to narrow them up and get some chances. But look, if we really attack them through the forwards, I think we've got some real talent. You know, Chloe again, Fran looks really sharp in the wing as well. So, you know, we'll have a look at, we'll do a bit of homework on the Irish and look to go back to back. I think we'll get a lot from this. We'll take a lot. You know, it's been 12 tough games, so we'll take a lot from this. We'll enjoy this evening, and then we'll certainly enjoy coming back in next week and get ready for Ireland.
And up to fourth in the table now, Brian. What a turnaround from just a few weeks ago.
Yeah, look, I think our barometer is not England and France. Let's be honest. You know, England and France are, you know, one in three in the world. We always knew that Wales, Italy and Ireland were the three teams that we would go after, especially at home. So, look, we said that there were some glimpses against England. There were some, certainly some glimpses against Wales, and there was a good 30-35 minutes against France last week, and we knew that if we put that together, we would come away with a victory. We've worked really hard on processes, mm-hmm. and if we got our processes right, the outcomes would take care of that, and I think today showed that.
It's paid off. It's great to be speaking about a victory, Brian. Thank you so much for joining us. Hopefully we're speaking about another one with you next week.
Thanks very much for having me. Thank you. Cheers.
Now, Lisa, some great moments of play. A player that we have to talk about, though, is Lana Skeldon. Two tries today. I'm sorry, we're going to talk about Leah Bartlett first. We're going to talk about Leah Bartlett and her two tries just in the second half. We can just take a look at that now, or we might actually take a look in. Yes, we are going to take a look at Leah Bartlett's try. It is just coming up now. Sorry, there we go. What a player, Lisa.
Yeah, I think we said the forwards really stepped up today, and Leah was one of the very front in that. Again, we're showing real good composure within the 22. We're really testing Italy here. And then again we tighten up and we're just so clinical in this area, which is maybe something we'd say we weren't doing very well at over the past couple of weeks. But it's just, again, we said that patience to work Italy really hard around those fringes, and then we just see Leah Bartlett then just sneak over and get that ball touched on the line.
And Leah to score twice as well, there wasn't even much time between the two of them.
No, not at all. But again, it just showed that forward dominance that we had today over Italy. And like Brian said, the set piece really stepped up today, especially having so many driving mauls. Again, hitting the tail of the line out, really making Italy work for this, work really hard defensively. But again, we're just coming, like Emma said earlier, we're just coming in and we're trying to fracture that Italy maul defence, get them moving around, and then we get that little bit of momentum there. And then Leah comes through, and it's just, again, another drop over the line. It's definitely, the amount of effort that was put in by the forwards is definitely 100% deserved it. You know, these guys are the main ones on the score sheet today.
So much better. And like Brian was saying, they only trained once together this week. But is that a credit to those professional contracts now and actually having that time to recover?
I think it is massively. I think if this was 2-3 years ago and you were told, you know, we only have one contact session as a squad, you know, you would have really seen the issues with that. But because they've been professional, because they've had all the contact time leading up to this tournament, like you said, all the work had already been done. A lot of it was just on homework and actually analysing, okay, what do we do well, what do we need to focus on, and look at ourselves as individuals and also as a squad. And it meant going into the one session they had together, they could be really, really particular on the little things that they needed to work on.
Well, let's look at Lana Skeldon now, another player who was fantastic for Scotland today, and two tries for Lana. But this is just, again, great play.
And being, it's basically exact same as last one, to be honest. I wish I'd knew a bit more about Linus. I'm sure it's a lot more in depth than what I'm giving it, to be completely honest. But again, it's just the processes. They know exactly how to keep it nice and tight. Lana's hidden at the back, and again, the minute she's that line, she's straight over. But it's all the work leading up to that. It was Eva Donaldson winning that ball in the air, and then everyone coming down, working nice and tight, and making sure Italy had no way of getting to that ball.
And now, looking ahead to next week, Ireland back here at the Damhealth, I'm sure the fans will be absolutely loving it again. But what will Scotland take from this and look ahead to now?
I think what they can take from it is just, like I said, all the way through this is set piece. You know, they're building a platform that we can use off the back of it. And in defence, we really fronted up. You know, we saw the dominance in our hits, our front-up tackles maybe against France and England. We're quite soft. Whereas now we actually saw a bit of ruthlessness. You know, we had a bit of fight between us. And, you know, once we got that one dominant hit, we backed it up with something else. And I want to see them continue to do that. Mm. And if we can get that kicking game working on point again, it's finding some grass, making the Irish back three work really, really hard and get some mistakes in there, we'll get some momentum going, points on the board, and we'll just keep going and make that one win into two.
And that's the thing, I mean, the forwards today were so strong, they were so powerful, and they really got the points on the board. But whenever Chloe Rowley had the ball, the crowd would just go absolutely mental. We saw a great run from Fran McGee too. There's players there who can really bring things forward in attack.
Yeah, 100%. We just need to give these guys opportunities. You know, we don't want these guys just waiting for the ball to be given to them. We want them to come looking for the ball so that they can have impacts in the middle. We want it to be exciting rugby. We want, you know, as a 10, I want to see more backs play. I want to see these guys tear Ireland apart in the middle. But yeah, we need those forwards again to give us really good go forward front foot ball so that we can get excited as a back line, go find that ball and make some line breaks. And once we're in behind, like you say, Chloe gets hands on ball in behind, she's dangerous because we've got no idea where she's going
to
go.
Well, some brilliant moments of magic to come, but let's actually take a look at what's coming up on the BBC. Tomorrow, Sports Scene is on at 7:15, featuring extended highlights of Aberdeen versus Rangers. Next Friday, it's live championship action from Dens Park at 7:30, Dundee versus Cove Rangers. On Saturday, we have the Scottish Cup semi-final, Falkirk versus Inverness Caledonian Thistle at 11:45 a.m. on BBC One Scotland. Also next Saturday, we'll be back here for Scotland versus Ireland and the Women's Six Nations from 7:15, rounding off the weekend with extended highlights of Rangers versus Celtic in the Scottish Cup on Sports Scene at 7:15 here on BBC Scotland. Lisa, thank you so much for joining us. I think we'll be talking about a Scotland win next week.
Oh, I'd like to think so for sure.
Hopefully we are. Well, anyway, thank you so much for joining us. We will see you back here next Saturday as Scotland host Ireland in the Women's Six Nations. See you then. Bye-bye. Green, green grass, blue sky. You better throw a party on the day that I die.